in Owosso, a weather bulletin at 3:35. National Weather Service Doppler radar confirmed a tornado 2 miles west of Chesaning, moving east at 40 miles per hour. If you live in the village of Oakley, Chesaning, or St. Charles, take cover immediately. You are in imminent danger. A tornado is approaching. Seek shelter immediately in a basement or a reinforced portion of the interior of your home now. This is a tornado warning from WOAP. At 3:35, National Weather Service Doppler radar confirmed a tornado 2 miles west of Chesaning, moving east at 40 miles per hour. If you are living in the village of Oakley, Chesaning, or St. Charles, please take cover immediately. You are in imminent danger. A tornado is approaching. Seek shelter in a basement or reinforced portion of the interior of your home now. This is a tornado warning.
I said to the boys, we better get into the basement. So we unplugged the radio, took it downstairs, and we waited. At exactly 3:52, that storm hit us with a vengeance. Just wham! It hit the side of the house with such a force that the water was spurting about 2 feet out of the side wall. And my son looked at it and said, Mom, this just doesn't look good. In the middle of my basement, I have an old Michigan basement, there is a support wall that runs vertically and north-south, I mean, and east-west. We went around in so that the west wall was away from us and we were protected by it.
One, two, three, four.
I was up in Aubrey at my mom's cottage, and if people know, there was a tornado in Aubrey also, but luckily we were near Point Lookout and the tornado hit Point Aubrey.
And three summers ago, Charlie Stover and I decided that I needed a barn. I needed a storage place, and I had decided that this was going to be my, since I wasn't going to get a summer cottage, this was going to be my place. So we built this. I went out to Marion Springs and I cut a lot of the lumber in the wintertime. I'd taken out some trees and timber, mostly cottonwood and pine, white pine. And Charlie Stover really helped me a lot on this. He did the majority of the work, especially on the lower portion. And it's all 1-inch sheeting on there, cottonwood and pine sheeting, as opposed to doing just OSB board. And when we got all through with it, Charlie's comment to me was that that barn will outlast both of us, that it'll outlast us both. And I guess with the force of this wind, it didn't.
Wednesday afternoon, we were watching the TV, and the warnings came on that there was tornado warnings in Gratiot County. So we came in and turned on the National Weather Service and was watching the Doppler track the storm. And the low pressure center was right over Chesaning. So I watched it, and they, about a quarter after three, said that there was a funnel cloud sighted 9 miles west of Oakley. And for people in Oakley, Chesaning, the Lothrop, to take cover immediately.
We were quite fortunate in the storm and the fact that we got all our family back together before the tornado hit. We were all down huddled in our basement in the little bathroom area underneath the doorway, because that's where they said it's supposed to be the strongest. So we even had our littlest one, Chris, 11, he was protecting himself with a towel underneath the shower stall, so he was covering up for everything. But
so I went outside on the back porch because the weather just didn't look that threatening, and I thought basically it was going to go north of us. The wind was blowing towards the north, and we stood out on the back porch and watched, and it wasn't very threatening. And then just on the horizon, there was something that came down out of the sky, hit the ground, bounced back up. And I asked my son what he thought that was, and we didn't know, so we just watched it a little bit more. And all of a sudden, the clouds started to form on the ground, and they weren't coming from another area. They were coming out of the ground up into the middle of this one cloud. And I said to my son, where the hell are those clouds coming from? And he said, Mom, those aren't clouds, that's dirt.
July 7th, 1997. Staying right out of tornado funnels.
All the wind was coming from that way, and then it shifted to this way, and then I saw all these trees coming. Oh my God. Look at those. Oh, those maple, those beautiful walnuts. Oh, there's her oak. That, her oak's done. Took out her, one of her pine trees. Took the top off the other one.
I was just telling you how long you guys have those walnuts.
Oh, my God. Not good is right.
Complete blackout tonight in Chesaning. I guess you can say this storm has affected everyone who lives here, just some more than others. I saw several homes that suffered major damage.
Oh, we saw it. We saw the debris. We saw it come down and zip right through here.
when my ears started popping, and I could hear where the pressure, because I had all my doors and windows closed. I didn't open anything, so I could hear the pressure, and I just felt like everything was going to squeeze in.
The people of Chesaning knew it was coming, but just could not stop it.
Well, this is the garage, or what's left of it. The roof has been taken about a mile out into the fields, the kid said, and probably a third of the house itself caved in inside.
The tornado ripped the roof right off Jeff Murdoch's house. This is what's left of his kitchen. When you have a tree not on your house, you have a tree in your house.
Right, yep, in it, yep, literally in it, yep.
This couple says they feel they were hit twice, once when the storm came through, a second time when they saw their son's bedroom.
We started looking around, and then he came and got me, and he said that the tree had fallen into my son's room.
The tornado left its mark on homes and apartments.
I couldn't believe it. I didn't think it was really that bad until I came out to this side and I seen all this torn down and the roof was just off. And then when I went around the other corner and seen all the trees up from the ground, it was just terrible. I couldn't believe it.
If you've never experienced a tornado, you're wondering what it's like. The people here tell me that they feel humbled by the storm, grateful to be alive. And a lot of them say they had the same experience. They felt some popping in their ears just before the storm hit, and that's how they knew it was going to happen. I know, Bill, you were in the heart of the storm. Did you have that same experience?
Front moved west to east, roughly following M57. The damage started in Chesaning. That's where Jim Kirzner is this noon hour. Jim, where do things stand right now?
Leslie, it's been cleaning up all morning, and you hit the nail right on the head. Southern Saginaw County, Northern Genesee County, right along M57, the hardest hit. We're on the Gary Gross Farm, which is southeast of Chesaning. There have been dozens of neighbors and friends showing up this morning to help in the cleanup. During the noon hour right now, they're taking a little lunch break. Take a look up top. This is just one of several buildings that was blown off the foundation. Now, as the camera moves left, you can see all the hard work the people have been doing out here this morning, cleaning up, but also take a look at this pile of wood, what's left of several of the farm buildings out here. And also, take a look at yesterday afternoon and what caused all the trouble.
This is July 2nd, 1997. We just had a tornado go through here. Our house is still here, and our neighbor homes are still here. We have one garage down. Trees are down all over. There's lots of damage done. It was very, very scary. Neighbors just put up a new pool. The road was blocked, but Persinski's went and cleared the trees off.
look at Randy Horner's front yard. Stop. Don't park underneath the power line, honey. House doesn't look like it got hit bad.
July 2nd. Happened at 10 to 4 today. Came through. Be in our front yard, this pine tree. This is going down Wood Street. I can't believe it just got uprooted.
pulled the cement right up and everything.
Oh my God, it sure did.
Look at this tree I got yanked out.
This may be one of the few grins you see today in Chesaning. The town has a lot to be thankful for, but little to smile about.
My wife and I both, and including my daughter, when we drove up, it was like you just turn white inside. I mean, you don't even know what to think. Driving through Chesaning, the one thing you'd have to notice is the sheer random nature of this storm. Looking at this house, you'd never believe a storm rolled through here yesterday. But if you walk across the street to his neighbor's house, there'd be little doubt in your mind that this storm was a powerful one.
That's like a war zone. I've never seen anything like this in all the years that I've lived here.
As bad as the storm left Chesaning, even the people who sustained damage say they're lucky because they realize how bad it could have been.
We thank God that there were absolutely, from what our knowledge was, no injuries in town. I mean, this is something that you wouldn't believe when you see what you see here.
I've seen worse. I lived through the Beecher tornado.
And in 40 more years, people in Chesaning will recall this storm in much the same way. They'll be the survivors, and so will their town.
And fascia board missing along the south side of the house up the top. These are five trees along the driveway that are now missing. This was all from a storm on July 2nd, 1997.
Elm and oak trees here that slammed against the side of our house, knocked our chimney off, and we could actually feel the ground shake when all these trees were hitting our house, and the chimney, about a 10-foot section, fell off. That hit the ground. I don't know how much weight that is, but that was enough to be felt inside the house. We were very, very fortunate. When it finally stopped, I came up and we saw our roof of our deck, which was about 1 foot off the deck. Now the roof was completely covered by an 80-foot elm tree, and it looked like a war zone. I remember saying, oh my God, because I expected to see a little bit of siding flying by, a few limbs. We always lose some limbs from the trees, but I had no idea we'd have 12 trees out of probably 15 trees we have down here.
Chesaning is cleaning up as we speak, Audrey. It is just an awesome, it's deja vu. It's Kevin Carpenter, Randy Conant, Peggy Agar said all day, it's deja vu with Frankenmuth. The cleanup is continuing, but in less than 6 hours, we are living on warm pop, no power whatsoever. The lights here are courtesy of ABC 12, but there is no stopping the village of Chesaning tomorrow. They're going to be vibrant. They're going to be alive. They're asking for a couple of volunteers to come down to help clean Showboat Park. But no one is hurt. There are no fatalities. There is excitement here in the village of Chesaning.
And in Chesaning, the same type of undying spirit could be felt throughout the community.
Oh, no question. When everybody's got to pitch in, it brings people closer together. But that's part of the character of the town. And you don't like these events to do it, but it does bring people together.
And together, this group will work to straighten things out for the upcoming Showboat Weekend.
when a tragedy like this hits a town, you really don't know how much people care about you until something like this happens. And one of the things that just really impressed me about this town, about my neighbors, is first of all, we had adequate warning. We had more than adequate warning. We had a full 7 minutes of that air raid siren. I mean, I'm the furthest out of town. I had 7 full minutes to prepare. That's a tribute to the fire department. It's a tribute to the weather forecasting. I'm so impressed with that whole service. I will never doubt Doppler radar again. I always thought it was kind of a joke, actually. But
I really would like to thank everybody who came over here and helped move out this mess, because really we had water damage and broken things and messed up things, and especially, can I name some people that came on that? Well, on Thursday, like Jeff said, the Rocky Chamberlain, and then there were people from the church, the Reeves, Doug and Diane, and their two boys came over, and then the Birches, Brianna Birch and her mom and dad, Randy and Paula, were here, and they even brought a apartment-sized refrigerator for us at the Bonnie Mill, so we can keep some pop in there while we're our kind of interim stay. And then our pastor was here, and the Kensroots, and Mary Van Loon, and Tom and Thomas Nelson, and just so many people, and people at church were praying for us. But we're okay. We're here, and we got our families together, right? So that's what counts, really.
People started coming by with chainsaws and wheelbarrows and started diving in and cutting the trees. And I have a little tennis injury, so I couldn't do anything but serve tea. But people started digging in on the chainsaw gang, and we had probably 8 or 10 people hauling wood. And in less than 5 hours, we had probably moved 5 tons of wood off those two driveways, and we were able to get out before dark. And the hardest working people, I mean, I said to somebody, I think I said to Dan Lee, that I said it almost made me cry, and it really did, because some of the people I didn't even know. It was just people that just came out of the woodwork to help people out. They knew we needed the help, and it was really, really heartwarming.
The other thing is people, your neighbors, as soon as they feel safe enough to come out, they come and check on you, and you hear them across the field, "Stu, are you okay?" You know, and you just flash them and say, "Yeah, I'm fine. How about you? We're fine. Do you need any help?" "No, I'm okay. Does anybody need help?" And then neighbors down the road, one in particular, my friend Tom, rode his bike down here. "Are you okay, Sue?" "Yeah, I'm fine. Where are you going?" He says, "Well, I know that you can't get a car through town," which at that time I had no idea that, you know, there was anything in town left. And he was so concerned about getting uptown to see if Paula was okay. You know, so God love him. I don't even know if he made it through town, because Pete Road was impassable.
But the community, you know, we could have done it without the help of friends and neighbors. No doubt about that.
We haven't had to cook a meal all week. People keep bringing by casseroles and delicious pies and raspberry pies and stuff like that. And I kept reminding the kids. I said, "Well, Kelly," I said, "see this?" I said, "That's why we live in a town like Chesaning." I said, "You wouldn't see that in a town like Detroit or even Flint or Saginaw." I said, "That's what it's all about, is a community that pitches in and helps each other out when there's time of need." So that was really heartwarming for me.